it used to be, but I've gone through quite a long process of treatment over the years, so it doesn't really bother me now, to be honest.
You've got a handle on it,
yeah, so to speak. It's something that you accept now and learn to live with and manage it in your own way.
Now, you use that magic word there, and thank you very much. You use the word manage.
Yeah.
A lot of people talk about, certain people talk about curing post-traumatic stress disorder. I personally don't believe in that. I think there are ways to treat it and ways to manage it afterwards.
Yeah. I don't think there is a cure, to be honest. I think if you've got PTSD, you've got it for life. It's just a case of recognising the signs and the symptoms and managing it accordingly as best you can, to be honest. That's what I truly believe.
And I'm right alongside you on that. I hate the words cure and eradicate. Treatment and management, and as you say, you've got to recognise the signs. Once you said you've had treatment, so have I. Once that treatment has been helpful, you then learn your own signposts or warning signs.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you learn the techniques then to actually do something about it to stop that signpost actually smacking you on the nose.
Yeah.
Right, mate, is there anything, I mean, in Chester, you're going to be sleeping in doorways and that, is there anything else you'd like to say to the public? I mean, anybody that's listening in from that area, please get up there
I'd like to give the website. We've got a Virgin Just Giving page if people would like to sponsor the event. If they go on to www.soldiersoffthestreet.co.uk and the Virgin Giving page is on their website, you just click onto it and put a small donation in. And every single penny that's collected from Soldiers Off the Street goes directly to the lads. None's taken out for wages or rent or anything. Every single penny goes straight to the lads that we help.
Yep. Thank you for that. It's exactly what I wanted you to do right there, right then. And I do know that every penny does go. As I say, I've done some work with Soldiers Off the Street, helped them collecting and that. You know, I know what you're saying is pucker. Anything else you'd like to stick in there, fella?
That's about it, basically. If anyone's in Chester from the 31st or popping in for a visit, just bring me a hot pie and a cup of tea. Because that's what I'll be relying on, to be honest.
Yeah. So, will you have any notification with your signpost that you are doing this for Soldiers Off the Street, or are you?
Well, I'm reporting in every morning, so it'll be on the Soldiers Off the Street website as to where I'll be. But the main sort of focused area that I'll be in is the square in front of the cathedral and the cenotaph at the top of the high street. I'll be sort of hanging about there most days. Which is where all the foot traffic go.
Yeah, probably.
I've got a big sign.
Yeah.
So if you just see a lonely guy sitting with a combat jacket on with a big sign in front of him, that's me.
Okay, that's again exactly the sort of info I needed out of you. Les, thank you very much. Okay, then, mate. Well, again, respect to you for doing this. You're a braver man than I, Gunga Din, with the weather you've got facing you. But, respect, and on behalf of all those that soldiers in the street unfortunately have to help, you're raising awareness of the situation. That help will get through to some of them. So on their behalf, mate, I would like to say thank you.
You're welcome, and let's all take successful.
I'm sure it will be. If it helps one person, then the job is jobbed, all right? Let's hope it helps more.
Absolutely.
Yeah. But,
okay.
Okay, then, Les.
Thanks very much.
All right, thank you. Cheers, mate.
Thank you. My pleasure. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Cheers, then. Bye-bye. An interview with Les Standish. And as he said, he's going to be out on the streets over the next week. The streets of Chester, living rough. I don't envy the guy that. He's going to be sleeping in doorways, etc., sleeping bag, combat jacket. Bit of a sign there advertising what he's going to be doing. Looking for people to show their generosity. Particularly through Bonfire Night. I mean, I know Lawrence was mentioned it on the his programme earlier this evening. I've been listening to the fireworks going off most of the evening out the back. For a lot of X-Forces personnel, this is a very rough period of the year because of that and the memories that those bangs evoke. So good luck to Les. Anybody in the Chester area over the next week or so, search him out in the town centre and please show your support for the fantastic work that soldiers off the street do. Okay, good evening, Natalie. Good evening, Canada. How you doing, my sweetheart? Nice to have your company. Couple of minutes, we have got those old boys, Mel and Michael, coming live on the telephone. But we'll get around to that in a few minutes. I'm going to play one track before then, in keeping with what Les has just been talking about, in keeping with what Veterans Radio Net is all about. It's about brothers and sisters, being there for brothers and sisters. This is The Soldiers and Requiem for a Soldier. I'll be back shortly.
You're listening to Veterans Radio Net, around the UK and the world.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. And no, Sapagen doesn't do this thing usually, but... Our Father, for what we are about to receive, I do hope we don't get banned from the radio. I hope the curtains are clean. I hope the port, or the bottle of port, is still reasonably full. And I hope that the bottle of cheap red wine has not been opened yet. Guys, this is something we haven't tried for a while. And yes, Robert, it is. It's the Band of Brothers soundtrack. It's the actual, just the instrumental version of that is one I close a lot of my shows with. But there you go. Yeah, Robert, lol. Yep, you know what's coming. We're about to do a live telephone link. Now, during the next track, I shall hook up. And then, hopefully, we will have Mel and Michael online, on the phone, so that you can hear us talk live. We've gone all the way on this, guys. I mean, we have spared absolutely no expense. The equipment has cost me £19 something. Let's see if we can get enough blue tack and enough gaffer tape on it to make it work properly. The test went okay earlier on, but now for the two old scroats that are going to be on the line in a minute, for the likes of Robert and Graham, here's Middle of the Road, and this is Chirpy Chirpy Cheep Cheep. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Chirpy Chirpy Cheep Cheep, there for the old guard. Now, we're going back in time here.
time travel to the distant past when Sapper Ken was the only person on Veterans Radio Net.